Hi, today I would like to discuss with you five main differences between turbocharged engines and naturally aspirated engines. The first one would be torque. Turbocharged engines have much more torque compared to a naturally aspirated engine. When the turbo kicks in, it forces air into the cylinder, and thus we can burn more fuel produce more power out of the same displacement compared to a naturally aspirated engine. Adding a turbo to an engine has allowed manufacturers to downsize their engines. So now we can see 1 liter turbocharged engines in 3 cylinders, which produce more power than a 2 liter naturally aspirated engine used to produce a few years ago. The second main difference is reliability. A naturally aspirated engine is much more reliable compared to a turbocharged engine, and the reason is quite simple. The mean effective pressure in a turbocharged engine is much higher compared to the naturally aspirated one. A turbocharged engine basically uses the exhaust gases to move a compressor to introduce more air into the cylinder, and then we can use more fuel to burn to obtain more power. Obviously, this will increase engine wear, and reliability is highly affected. There have been engines not long ago which could have run for over 1 million kilometers. Right now, turbocharged engines don't have this performance anymore. Manufacturers are looking at the magic number of 300,000 kilometers. They guarantee 300,000 kilometers for every engine. The third main difference is turbo lag. In order to get that pressurized exhaust gases to move the compressor, you need a specific number of RPM. Turbo generally kicks in from around 1500 RPM, or even at 2000 RPM, it simply depends on each car and each engine. And until you get that pressure, when you kick down the acceleration pedal, it takes about a second or a fraction of a second. Twin turbocharged engines have reduced this turbo lag, but it can't compare to a naturally aspirated engine. That's why many manufacturers, especially those who produce sports cars such as Lamborghini or Ferrari, still use naturally aspirated engines. However, in order to get that huge amount of power, they need to use huge engines. A 5.2 V10 naturally aspirated engine in the Lamborghini Huracan, for example. The fourth main difference is compression ratio. In order to burn more fuel, you need a larger combustion chamber. To achieve that, the compression ratio needs to be slightly smaller compared to a naturally aspirated engine. Sports cars which use direct injection can have compression ratios of up to 12.5, which is high. They can't use a higher compression ratio because gasoline will auto-ignite, and you don't want that. It will produce engine knocking. It's called engine knocking, and it will destroy the engine. In turbocharged engines, compression ratio is slightly smaller. For example, the Volkswagen Golf or Passat have a 2.0 liter FSI with direct injection gasoline engine, and they have two versions of the same engine. One is naturally aspirated and the second is turbocharged. The first one has 150 bhp and a compression ratio of 11.5 or 12, around that number, while the turbocharged engine has 10.5 or 10.3. So the manufacturer slightly reduced the compression ratio in order to enlarge the combustion chamber. And the fifth main difference is maintenance. When you purchase a car with a turbocharged engine, it's slightly more expensive than a naturally aspirated one, and maintenance costs over the long run are pretty expensive. A week ago, in a car service that I work, a Volkswagen Golf 5 had the turbo replacement. The entire turbo system was replaced, and it costs around $800, so it's not cheap. Also, by having a turbocharged engine, injectors need to inject fuel at much higher pressure, and this would also be more expensive. If the injectors get damaged and they need to be replaced, they will be more expensive compared to a naturally aspirated engine. Alright, this being said, I'll talk to you guys in the next video. Thanks for watching.